Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. In this video, we go over adding and subtracting fractions that have a common denominator, but we deal with the negative numbers, and we do the following seven problems on this video. In this problem, we're adding two fractions that have a common denominator, but we're adding a negative and a positive number. So we've got to use the rules for adding positive and negative numbers and the rules for adding fractions that have a common denominator. One thing to notice here is when you see this minus sign out in front of the fraction bar, that means it's a negative number. It doesn't mean negative 3 over negative 8. If you want to write it as just what's in the numerator, it's a negative 3 over a positive 8. You need to have the same exact number in the denominator. Okay? So if you had put an extra negative sign here, then that would be positive 3/8, not negative 3/8, right? So keep that in mind. All right, now we use the rules for adding fractions. When you have a common denominator, you've got an 8. You just write down the denominator once, right? It's like you got negative 3 of these things plus 1 of these things. Negative 3 plus 1 is negative 2/8, because right there's more negatives and you're adding different signs, so you take the difference, so it's negative 2, and then you simply reduce that to, well, is it going to be a negative or positive? One negative sign, so it's a negative, and then we reduce 2/8. Divide the numerator and denominator by 2 gives you 1/4. Okay, now you might not need to show all of these steps. A lot of this could be done at your head. You might go directly to that step. You write down the 8, you add negative 3 plus 1, and then reduce it. Right, here's one for you to try. So try this one on your own. Negative 5/11 plus negative 3/11. All right, let's see. It has a common denominator. So we know it's going to have 11 in the denominator. And then we're going to add the numerator. So what is the numerator of the first one? Remember, this minus sign can go with that numerator. So that's a negative 5 plus a negative 3, which is negative 8/11. So you could write your answer like that with a negative 8 over 11, or you could put the minus sign in front of the fraction bar and write it as negative 8/11. What's not a good idea is to put the negative in the denominator. Although technically it's not, it's not wrong. You'll usually see negative fractions written with a minus sign right in front of the fraction bar or in the numerator, keeping the denominators positive. All right, here's the next one for you to try. Put the video on pause and try this problem, and you want to reduce it as much as possible. All right. We have a common denominator of 12s. So we could think of that, I'm just going to write this out. You could think of that as negative 5/12 plus 1/12. Make sure you have exactly the same denominator. So our denominator will be 12. And we have negative 5 plus 1. You're adding a negative and a positive this time. So that'll give you a negative 4. And then I've got a negative divided by a positive, so that's going to be a negative for my answer, and then we just have to reduce the 4/12. So be careful when you reduce that you don't say the answer is 3. You divide the numerator and denominator by 4, right? So you are going to have a 1 in the numerator. So negative 1/3. And again, it's okay to write it as a negative 1 in the numerator. I'm going to show you something a little tricky now. What if somebody had said to do this problem? 5 over negative 13 plus 1 over 13. So when you look at this problem, I hope you realize there is not a common denominator. One is negative 13 and one's positive 13. They are not the same. So you cannot just simply add the numerators and write 13, because what would you write for the denominator, 13 or negative 13? But they're almost the same, and the way to deal with this is to put the negative sign in the numerator, and that's the same thing. Negative 5 thirteenths is the same thing as 5 over negative 13, right? Because there's still just one negative sign. So this means 5 divided by 13 and the answer is negative. This means 5 divided by 13 and the answer is negative. So once you do that, then you have a common denominator. So that's why it's confusing when you have a minus sign in the denominator. Okay, the rest of this shouldn't be too difficult. We've got a common denominator of 13 and you add the numerators. So negative 5 plus 1 will be negative 4. And that doesn't reduce, so that would be our final answer to that one. So just be careful. Make sure the denominator is exactly the same. All right, let's do a subtraction problem that has, we have a common denominator. I have 3 tenths minus 7 tenths. All right, so what do we do when we do subtraction and you have a common denominator? You just write the denominator down, and that's 3 minus 7. The only difference is I have to deal with subtracting, right? 3 minus 7. So remember, that's 3 plus a negative 7. So you could write plus a negative, and that will give me then what for my numerator. 3 plus negative 7 is negative 4 tenths. And now I need to reduce that as well as decide if that's positive or negative. If I have a negative divided by a positive, it's negative, and let's see. Reduce 4 tenths, divide the numerator and denominator by 2, you should get negative 2 fifths. So sometimes when you subtract with common denominators, you might get a negative number. So here's one for you to try. Negative 4 fifteenths minus 3 fifteenths. So put the video on pause and try that on your own. All right, so we have a common denominator, right? So we've got negative 4 minus 3. And now we have to just use the rules for, you know, subtracting with negative numbers here. I can change that to negative 4 plus a negative 3. Which will give you a negative 7 fifteenths in the numerator. You can keep that negative 7, or you could write that with a minus sign out in front. Negative fifteenths. So I'm still using my rules for subtracting with fractions. It's just that I'm also having to deal with adding and subtracting positive and negative numbers. So here's another one for you to try on your own. So put the video on pause and try it on your own first. Okay, we've got negative 15 eighteenths minus a negative 2 eighteenths. Okay, the first thing you might notice is when you have minus a negative, that means adding the opposite, you're going to get plus a positive. So in other words, you'll have negative 5 over 18 plus a positive 2 over 18. All right, so I have a common denominator. Now I'm adding. So you just add the numerators. So what's a negative 5 plus 2? You've got more negatives than positives, so you take their difference, which is 3. And there's more negative signs, so it's negative 3 eighteenths. So my answer is going to be negative because I have a negative divided by a positive. So my final answer is going to be negative. And I just need to reduce 3 eighteenths. So what goes into both those numbers? 3. So that'll be negative 1 sixth. And that's the answer to that one. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.